all right, let's see now what is the meaning of anomalous expansion of water. You will know what is the thermal expansion. The expansion of a body on heating is known as the thermal expansion. Now what is the meaning of anomalous expansion? Anomalous expansion means, you know that on heating water from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, it contracts instead of expansion, and cooling water from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius, or extracting the heat energy from water from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius, it expands. This is called as the anomalous expansion of the water. So the expansion of the water when is cooled down from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius is known as anomalous expansion of water. You may note it down. The expansion of water when it is cooled from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius is called anomalous expansion. Expansion of water. So this is the definition of the anomalous expansion of water. Let us see, now I will show you the variation of the volume and the temperature by plotting the graph when the water is heated from 0 to 10 degree Celsius. So this is your volume in centimeter cube, and this is your temperature in degree Celsius. So this is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. We'll consider from 0 to 10 degree Celsius. So here I am giving the volume. Say volume is, here it is 0.9999, then this is 1.0000, then 1.0001 1.0002, 1.0003. So on heating water from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, what happens? Whenever you heat the water from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, it contracts. Means the volume of the water decreases. Contraction means what? The volume is decreasing. Suppose we are starting the volume here. Now when the temperature is coming from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, how the graph will come? It will come in this way. And again further heating from 4 to 10 degree Celsius, what happened to the volume? Again volume increases. So this is how we can draw the volume and temperature graph. See over there, when the water is heated from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, this is temperature in degree Celsius, and this is your volume in centimeter cube. Initially, suppose we have taken the volume over here, that is slightly above 1.0001 centimeter cube. So here the volume was there in initial volume. Now whenever it is heated from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, what is happening to the volume? It is decreasing. Decreasing or not? The graph is coming in this manner. So the volume is decreasing, along with that the temperature is increasing. Again the volume is becoming least at 4 degree Celsius. Again, further heating, what is happening to the volume? Volume is increasing in this way. The volume becomes more. Gradually, it is becoming now, it was say 1 centimeter cube. At 4 degree Celsius, the volume of the water is 1 centimeter cube. Again, when you are increasing the temperature, the volume is increasing. Here, the amount of water is taken as 1 gram. Remember, how much water? Water is equals to 1 gram. So therefore, 1 gram of water when heated initially from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, the volume of the water decreases and the volume of the water becomes least at 4 degree Celsius, that is how much? 1 centimeter cube. So here the volume of the water is least, how much is becoming? 1 centimeter cube at 4 degree Celsius. Now further heating from 4 to 10 degree Celsius, what is happening? The volume is increasing. So this is the variation of volume and temperature graph. Let us see the variation of density and temperature. Suppose this is your density in gram per centimeter cube and this is your temperature in degree Celsius. Now say the temperature is here 0, then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Now we are heating the water from 0 to 10 degree Celsius. Here the amount of water is 1 gram. 1 gram of water. Remember this. Here is 0.9999. Now 0.9998. Here it is 0.9996, this point. Okay. Say initially the at 0 degree Celsius the density of the water was here. Slightly less than 0.9999 gram per centimeter cube, and it is more than 0.9998 gram per centimeter cube. So whenever the water is heated initially from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, what happened? The density will increase, and it will increase up to what? 1 gram per centimeter cube. When the water is heated from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, what happened? The density of the water increases. Suppose the density is starting from here and the density will increase. Again, further going from 4 to 10 degree Celsius, the density will become less. So from here, the graph will become in this way. So this is your variation of density and temperature. See you, what is happening? At 4 degree Celsius, the density of the water, 1 gram of water is becoming maximum. That is how much? 1 gram per centimeter cube. So the density of water at 4 degree Celsius, how much is 1 gram per centimeter cube? If you are taking 1 gram of water and it is here 1000 kg per meter cube. So this is how the density of the water is changes whenever it is heated from 0 to 10 degree Celsius. So let's see now Hope's experiment. Hope's experiment to demonstrate the anomalous expansion of water. Now T.C. Hope designed one apparatus where it can be demonstrated the anomalous expansion of water. You will know what is the anomalous expansion of water, just now I have told you. So the scientist T.C. Hope has designed one apparatus in order to demonstrate the anomalous expansion of water. This is the Hope's apparatus, and in this apparatus long cylindrical metallic vessel is used. This is the cylindrical vessel. You can see this is the metallic cylindrical vessel, and there are two openings in this vessel. One is point P, another is point Q. Point P is near top and point Q is near bottom. And the central portion of this cylinder is having containing a cylindrical trough in which a freezing mixture of ice and salt is provided. This is the freezing mixture of ice and salt. This is the trough which is cylindrical in the shape. Now you can see there are two thermometers, thermometer T1 and thermometer T2. Thermometer T1 is placed near the upper end, that is near the end P, whereas thermometer T2 is kept near the end Q, or at the bottom of the cylindrical vessel. The work of this thermometer is to record the temperature of the liquid at a regular interval of time. Now see, what is the observation is found over here. Understand the observation. At first, both the thermometer, that means this thermometer T1 and T2 measures the same temperature, that is at the room temperature. The room temperature of the liquid will be measured by both the thermometer T1 and T2 initially. Now after some time, what happened? The temperature recorded by the thermometer T2 gradually falls down, and it is gradually falling down from the room temperature to 4 degrees Celsius. Therefore 4 degrees Celsius is marked over here, you can see there. So after some time, the temperature recorded by the thermometer T2 gradually falls to 4 degrees Celsius. And at this moment of time, at this time, the temperature recorded by the thermometer T1 does not change. It remains almost same, that is the room temperature. Now, after some time again, what happened? The temperature recorded by the thermometer T2 remains fixed at 4 degrees Celsius. So at 4 degrees Celsius, there will be no change of the temperature recorded by the thermometer T2, or it remains steady, it remains constant. At this time, now what happened? The temperature recorded by the thermometer gradually falls up to 0 degrees Celsius. So before it was how much? Say 12 degrees. I have given here, you can see the experiment. See the graph, this was given there, 12 degrees Celsius. So now what happened? When the temperature of the thermometer T2 becomes steady at 4 degrees Celsius, then the temperature of the thermometer T1 gradually falls from 12 degrees Celsius, or from the room temperature, to 0 degrees Celsius. So this is what is observed from the Hoff's experiment. Now you can see the temperature time curve which I have drawn over here for you. Now see, this is for the thermometer T1 and this is for thermometer T2. See what is happening. In the thermometer T1, initially there is no change of the temperature. When in the thermometer T2, the temperature is falling from the room temperature to 4 degrees Celsius. See, you can see here, when the temperature of the thermometer T2 is falling from 12 degrees Celsius, here it is taken room temperature as 12 degrees Celsius, it is falling to 4 degrees Celsius. At the same time, there is no change of the temperature of the thermometer T1. So the AB part of the graph for the T1 is remaining constant, means there is no change of the temperature recorded by the thermometer T1. But at the same time, for the thermometer T2, what is happening? The temperature is gradually falling from 12 to 4 degrees Celsius. So therefore, the AB part of the graph in both the cases is, you can see now, here AB part of the graph, this is the fall of the temperature. Here AB part of the graph is remains constant. Now after some time, when the temperature of the thermometer T2 remains steady at 4 degree Celsius. See, now BC part of the graph is showing that one. It remains steady at 4 degree Celsius. This is the 4 degree Celsius and it remains constant over there. There is no change, no fall again. At the same time, what happened? The temperature recorded by the thermometer T1 is gradually falling from the room temperature to 0 degree Celsius. See over there. Therefore, the BC part of the graph of the thermometer T1 is the fall of the temperature. This is coming from the room temperature, this is the room temperature and this is the zero. So this is the variation of the temperature time curve for the Hope's experiment. Now let us see why it happens. What is the reason behind that? So understand now the concept of this. See what happened over here. This is the container, the cylindrical container in which this is the trough, cylindrical trough, and which is containing the freezing mixer. Freezing mixer means what? It is the temperature is very less, means at the 0 degree Celsius you may consider, isn't it? Now whenever the trough cools down the water present at the central portion, because it starts cooling the water present at the central portion initially. So therefore, the water present at the central portion of the cylinder start contract, and because of which the density of the water becomes more. And this water during this time, what happened? Sinks down, moves down. Before that, the temperature recorded by both the thermometer was how much? 12 degree Celsius. As I told you, this was at the room temperature. So it was 12 degree Celsius. Now when the cold water enter into the container below the trough or vessel below the trough, the temperature gradually decreases. Therefore, the thermometer which was recording earlier 12 degree Celsius now falls down rapidly. And this process continues till the temperature of the entire water in the trough below the in the vessel below the trough becomes 4 degree Celsius. This remains. And at the same time, what happened in the water present in the upper part of the container? There will be no change. So therefore, the temperature remains say 12 degree Celsius, almost same. There will be no change of the temperature. Now when the entire portion at the point Q is becoming 4 degree Celsius, what happened now? Further cooling the water in the central portion below 4 degree Celsius, now it is coming what? 4 degree Celsius. Now again when it is cooled below 4 degree Celsius due to anomalous expansion of the water, what happened? The water starts expansion or expanding, and due to which the density of the water present in the central portion of the vessel becomes less, decreases. And because of this reason, what happened? This water present in the central portion of the container or the vessel rises on upward direction or rises on top. And due to convection, the water present on the top comes down to take its place. Now therefore, since here what type of water is there? Cold water is there. Now when this water is going on top, so what is happening? It is making this area cold. Therefore, the temperature of the thermometer T1 now falls down, and it will fall down to 0 degree Celsius. Then the temperature will become 0 degree Celsius. So at this point of time, what happened? Now when the temperature of the water present on the upper part of the vessel becomes 0 degree Celsius, it comes to the freezing point, so it starts freezing, and therefore the temperature remains constant, that is 0 degree Celsius. So at this point we find the temperature recorded by the thermometer T2 is almost 4 degree Celsius, and the density of the water at this container is maximum, and at the same time the temperature recorded by the thermometer T1 is 0 degree Celsius. That is because the freezing is taking place. Now, the first part of this explanation you can see from the part AB of the graph. See what I told you. Initially, what happened? Initially, there will be no change of the temperature of the thermometer T1, whereas the thermometer T2 gradually falls down, isn't it? See over there, this is for T2 and this is for T1. In T2, every part of the graph is showing what? Fall of the temperature from 12 to 4 degrees Celsius. Whereas the every part of the graph shown over here is remains constant, because initially there will be no change of the temperature of the thermometer T1. Now when the entire portion over here is becoming 4 degrees Celsius, then what happened? Again the temperature in this portion is falling down. That means it is coming from 12 to 0 degrees Celsius. So that is the second part, which is shown by the point B and C. See over there. Here when in the part BC, you find that for thermometer T1, the temperature is falling down from 12 to 0 degrees Celsius. At the same time, the temperature in the thermometer T2 is remaining what? Constant. That is 4 degrees Celsius. So this all about the explanation of the Hobbes experiment. Thank you.